Hello and welcome to my Hearts of Iron 3 Let's Play. It is episode 15 of my Italy Let's Play. Now, last episode, unfortunately, for some strange reason, can't get my words out. For some reason, the audio for my microphone cut out and wasn't working properly. I can't talk. So, I've decided that I am going to just leave it, you know, and not bother, like, taking a video down because of just how long it takes to actually upload, etc. Last episode, we sort of got defeated around here, and we had to pull back. So, not good. What's also even worse is the fact that Germany is also being pushed back in the south. Near Crimea, actually, which is this bit, which is there's a little conflict going on, a little situation. But in Asia, it's going pretty well, to be honest. Nothing terrible is really happening. Now, my aim of this is to just try and get as many people in the war as possible now for this episode. I also want to try and defend this, you know, and not be, you know, completely crushed and pushed back. So I'm just going to try and hold this, and then also get people involved. So I'm going to speed it up to 3. So let's actually have a look then. We could do with getting, realistically, Romania involved. Because look at how many troops they've got. Even though they're not that skilled, they're still good. Now, I don't know why these people are not able to join the war. I mean, it's not like they are in some sort of agreement with Russia. I'm going to revert debt. Oh, I can't do anything with that. I also want Bulgaria to join as well. And I can't add them. It's very annoying, I don't know why. I mean, they don't have any... You know, they've only got military access through Albania. So there's no real reason. I mean, Hungary, they're not even involved, and they can't join. I just don't understand it. It's quite confusing, to be honest. Japan, I don't believe they can. Nope, they can't either. Is there anything I can do? No. Now, if I could make peace with them, which I can't, and then attack them, it might do something, but no, that's not going to work. So, yeah, there's nothing I can do whatsoever. Which is, you know, quite the ball ache. Let's have a look. We'll take Egypt and the Middle East. We'll snatch that. What about these guys? I want French Morocco. I'm surprised we haven't lost all of our things yet. No, not quite. We are building more escorts and stuff, which is good. And more units, and the navy as well, which should be able to take on the British Navy, which is also a very good thing. So let's speed up a bit. Nuclear physics research. It's 1942. Now, civil nuclear research, that's good, that we're training that, whatever you want to call it. We need to keep. I want to concentrate on getting a nuclear bomb because that could change the war to our preferred. Oh shit! Now then, this isn't good because I think this is yes. Right. First of all, I want to quickly get these guys rounded up. Now this is a very big annoyance, but I can't do anything about this. I knew this was going to happen. I forgot about these troops, putting these troops here. So I'm going to send these guys up to there. I'm going to send these guys over here, but I'm actually going to send them here just to sort this situation out. And I'm going to pull these guys across as well. And that'll do. At least we are actually winning the battles over here, which is always good. As soon as they've done that, they can attack them. These guys can quickly attack these, and hopefully we'll... win. Now then. I don't like... Look at this, they're being pushed back all the time. Is there anything I can do that can help the Germans? And just watching them pushing them back by the second. Finland will even join. And this has been a massive balls up. Because I actually was thinking, just before I got dragged into the war, I was thinking of just declaring war on the Russians. But I chose not to. I chose to get invited to join the war. And I sort of wish I hadn't now, because obviously, if I hadn't, then, I would have been able to have declared war, and everyone in the Axis would have joined, and we would have probably taken them out by now. But obviously that's not the case. And these guys are storming ahead. The British have retaken this as well. The war's not looking good so far. We need a new big power to join. How's Brazil? Where are Brazil? Brazil are joining the Allies. Not good. These guys. I can't even invite them, can I? No. This is very, very annoying. Oh, another uprising. That'll be in France. And Egypt, I believe. But that's not a worry. Right, we'll get these coming up the back. Now they can attack them. These guys can try and hurry up. And we'll send these guys this way. They're off that way. These can actually go there, just for now. At least we've got more troops in this region. I completely forgot I stationed them 3 units of infantry there, to be honest. But, you know. If only I actually had enough troops, I would be able to just, help the Germans out. Fall of Leningrad. Just gonna have a quick search for Leningrad. Is it that? Yes. Well, that's always a good point. At least they're pushing back, but we just don't want them to get outflanked. That would be a major shit up. I'd like to call that. I mean, we are at least rounding these guys up, which is always good. How are the Saudis doing? They're still being drifted towards us, which is good. So Persia's not, however, because they must be getting influenced, yes. Portugal joining the Allies because of the United States. Peru. Oh dear. We need, to be honest, what we need is we need nationalist Spain, because if nationalist Spain can take Gibraltar and push from behind, I can push up here and I can station all my troops here and secure northern Africa. The troops that I've got left, I can probably send over, well, to launch an invasion of the United Kingdom. But I think there'd be probably more needed to help push Russia back. But, I can't do that. Now then. Well, these guys might as well just go there and then go straight to Aleppo. You're not really hearing a lot about the Syrian war, to be honest, which is quite surprising because it's still obviously going on. Still got a lot of civilians dying, unfortunately. But nothing seems to be being said, which is quite strange. But yeah, it's all to do with Crimea. Now, obviously, the whole situation started because there was a trade. There was two offers that the Ukrainian government could have taken. They could have taken the option to have a 10 billion gas and oil deal with Russia, which would save them a lot of money, or they could have a free trade agreement with the European Union. Now, because the government in Ukraine was pro-Russia, or pro-Moscow, as the media seems to call it, they chose to obviously go with the Russian deal. Now that made a lot of pro-West, pro-EU supporters very annoyed, and people started to obviously, go apeshit basically. So once they started going apeshit, the where should I put these? I'll send these guys down there. The Russia started influencing them and all this bullshit. And then the government got kicked out. This new interim president got put in. And then Russia sort of just invaded. Oh shit, here we go. Russia just sort of invaded Crimea and took it. Might as well move forward one, I suppose. Right, now I'm gonna try and push them back. Will I be able to do it? Probably not, but you know, what can I do? I mean, look at that, that's pretty good, of course. I'll get these guys, I can't yet. I mean, just wait. It's their armored division that are really sort of crippling me on this front. I mean, I just defeated the them with a mountain division, and it's not even mountainous. I'm gonna choose. I could do with letting these guys heal. Well, repair, I suppose. So I'll just sort of get these guys going. We've got more troops to. I'll station that in Geneva, or whatever you want to call it. These guys are still convoy raiding. If they're doing a good job, I don't know. Where else can we station some troops? Definitely need to really. I'll station some more there just in case there's an invasion. And these guys can probably. I don't know. I'll send these guys here. Transport them. See, the British are starting to arrive in all its glory now. I'm gonna push through and try and create a new front here. So I've gone too wide again. I keep doing that. It's rather annoying that I keep making the same mistake. I should have just waited for them to attack me and get tired. But nope, didn't do it. I'm actually gonna just pull back again. And we've cleared this up. So they're gonna return there. They're gonna stay up there. And we've secured this area once again, which is a good point. Japan, how are you doing? Not been invaded, have you? No. I could send, tell Japan to, you know, take like the Maldives, and take some more strategic points such as Bangalore, and what else? Mangalore as well, just to really cripple them in their colonies. That's what I want. I want them to get have a. The thing is, we don't really want to be crippling the British. I mean, we do, but for my sake. But I'm more concerned about Germany, if I'm honest. Oh, are they actually moving? They're actually attacking, surprisingly, because they seem to just stay there for quite a while. I'm gonna tell them to take all these places. Where else? Lahore or whatever, I don't know how the hell you pronounce it. All of these. We'll also take Dubai. And don't know, it's a bloody tricky one. I could tell them to just for the sake of it. I mean, they're not gonna do it obviously, but where else? Oh shit, they actually invaded. What about if we tell them to invade Manila? And also some other Philippine bases. I'm also going to tell them to take back whatever, don't even know how the hell you pronounce that. And I'm going to tell them to take this back as well. Along with. If I said Poland, I thought it was Poland then. I was going to say, what the hell? The Christ. Oh, they are being fucking pushed back. Come on! I need. I just seem to get further and further away from Moscow. Oh dear, dear God, dear God, dear God, dear God. Yeah, pull back. I'm sorry, pull back. I mean, look at how many troops I've got. We've probably actually got an equal amount, but mine are just not organised, etc. Who needs what? Well, these guys need it more, don't they? They've got less troops. So I think I'll end it here, guys. It's about a 15-minute episode, roughly. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to also check out my social media sites, Facebook, Twitter, Tumblr, in the description below. I say it every time. Sorry about last episode and the audio issue. So yeah, thanks for watching and